A lot of you who have been asking me this question should know what to do, what are the things involved, and how it looks like, all right? So I will be talking about working permit in North Cyprus, all right, and how to get it, and how the documents, or what are the documents required for you to get this document, all right? If you are new, my name is Milton, and for my newcomers, please do not go without subscribing. Subscribe now, you may forget. Thank you so much. For my returning subscribers, you are highly welcome, all right? Thank you so much for your love. So today, first of all, I want to appreciate those who are struggling, all right? I know life is not easy nowadays, so keep moving, keep pushing. You will be there very soon, all right? So now, I want to make you understand that for you to work in North Cyprus, you need a document called a working permit. Whether you are an international worker, whether you are an international student, or you are a visitor, all right, you need the document called a working permit. Now, I will start from here. Before, you could get the working permit in your passport, all right, like a stamp. For those of you who have passed through the Ajan airport, you understand what I mean by the stamp, because when you enter the Ajan airport, when you arrive North Cyprus, you will be given a stamp in your passport. Before, the working permit was done like that, all right? When you go to them, they will stamp it in your passport. But nowadays, and in the coming of the COVID-19, things have changed, all right? A lot of things have changed, so everything is done online. Now, for those who have seen the working permit or who have not seen it yet, for those who already know how the student permit looks like, the student permit is a paper. Oh, mine is not here. My own is not here. I wanted to show you a copy of it. But there is a video on my YouTube channel I did about student permits. Check my channel. You will find the video there, and the thumbnail of that video has the permit, all right? The permit is in blue color. It's something like a blue color, all right? But your student permit is going to be blue for the newcomers in North Cyprus or those who are moving. But the working permit has a yellow color, like this, my cloth, or this, my dress, all right? The working permit has a yellow color. It's different from the student permit, but they are all of the same design, okay? So that is what you need to know. But now, for you to get a working permit in North Cyprus, first of all, you need to get a job, all right? You must get a job out of North Cyprus. Now, when you get a job from North Cyprus, let me say, you cannot live in North Cyprus without these two documents: the student residence permit or the working permit. If you are in Cyprus or North Cyprus without these two documents, you are illegal, all right? You either get the student permit or the working permit. If you are in North Cyprus without any of them, you are not legal, and it's going to limit you from so many opportunities. All right, so many opportunities. I have mentioned all of these things on this YouTube channel. So please make sure you verify all the videos and watch them, okay? Now, again, when you apply, or let me say, if you get a working permit from a company in North Cyprus, you are not allowed to work for another company that didn't issue you the letter. For example, if company A or B give you a permit to work with them, you cannot work with C or D, all right, until the contract expires or the permit expires or your work contract expires, all right? That is how it is done in North Cyprus. And your permit is renewable after 3 months, all right? It is renewable after 3 months, all right? The working permit or the work contract, it is renewable after 3 months. And in case you have, let me say, violation of some rules, or maybe if you are treated badly in the company, or in case you have some shortages in your money or your wages or your revenue or your salary, you can complain to the labor office, all right, the people in charge of permits. Then they can readjust that, because I know some companies will be very funny, all right? I understand they will be very, very funny. Especially, that is why your permit is like the insurance, all right? Your working permit is like your insurance. Why your student permit is like your insurance, to secure you, because without these documents, anything that happens to you, blame yourself, all right? That is how it is. Though I understand, I was working without any of these documents because I needed the money, all right? But later on, something was done, all right? So that is what, even if you find yourself in a position where you are working without a permit, Always make sure that your employer is aware that you are this, but make sure you are a student, okay? It is going to save you a lot because you have the student permit. I hope you understand me, but anything that happen, you don't blame, you don't carry the cross, or let me say, the cost don't come on you. Only your employer, the person who employs you, the working permit. Don't forget that I said you must get a job out of Cyprus before you use the preliminary permit to come into Cyprus, all right? Without it, you are illegal, all right? But if you came in as a visitor using a visitor's card or visitor's invitation, something, then you eventually get a job, you can now apply for it, but it must be gotten to you, or your employer must get it within 15 days, all right? So that is how it is. Now, for the documents you will be needing, you need this preliminary permit or from your employee, all right? So that is what the first document. You also need to get, let me say, a passport, a valid passport, not the expired one, all right? Because there was one time I was talking to this Pakistani friend. He told me his passport has expired, and he was like asking me what to do. I was still very new in the country. I didn't know anything, so I told him to go ask the labor office, but it was somehow difficult because, you know, like I said, it is your employer, your employee that has to be following up your documents, all right? So that is what you need to understand. Now, again, the other document you need is your identity card to identify where you are coming from. You also need a document from the social insurance department, all right? The company is going to get that, not you. You also need a health document or a health insurance, all right? You have to go to the hospital, do some tests. Then after that, you'll get your result, health results. Then you also need to get a health insurance, all right? That is not coming from you anyways. Like I said, all of these documents, you only give them to your employee and he takes them and process all of them, all right? Then you also need the passport copy of the employee, and you also need a letter of guarantee from anybody. Anybody can sign that for you. You also need a written and signed contract between the two, and you also need an A4 paper from the social insurance company department showing the name of your employee, your name and the details on it, all right? So that is how for you to work in North Cyprus or to get a working contract or a working permit in North Cypress. That is the these are the documents you need and what you need to know. Like I said, get a job first, you move into North Cyprus, then their employee gets the document done, right? Not you. You only need to go do your test, then give all the documents to him. He process them, or the company, he process them. Then anything that happens, you don't blame yourself, or you are not to be blamed, all right? The employee makes sure that everything is intact. But if you have problems, go to the competent authorities and complain to them, because like I said, you never can tell. You may be undergoing some bad behaviors, or maybe abuses, or maybe shortage of salaries, and maybe unpaid salaries or bonuses and things like that, all right? So with that, you can go to the labor office or social security and complain to them, all right? And they will look into your matter. I hope the video was helpful. If not, please make sure you subscribe. If it was, please click that subscribe button straight away. If you leave it now, you will forget. Please, thank you so much for understanding, and until we meet again, peace. The pre-authorization or the preliminary permit, all right, they will collect it and send to you in your home country. Then you are using the pre-authorization to enter into North Cyprus, all right? Then when you enter into North Cyprus, you cannot go to your company. That is in case you get a job in North Cyprus, all right? Now, when you arrive in North Cyprus, you are given 15 days, all right? You are given 15 days to get the working permit, all right? To get the working permit. And you are not the one in charge of this permit. You are not the one to go look for your permit. You are not the one to produce your permit. It is your employer, the person who employed you, your employer, all right? You are the employee, right? Your employer is now going to follow up so that you get the working permit, all right? Your employer must follow up. It is a law. That is how it is. You don't produce your own permit, or you don't apply for it. Your employer follows up and give you the permit, and it must be done after 15 days when you enter into now Cyprus, all right? Now, a lot of people will ask, why is it like that, and why can't I get a job? I understand some people will still come asking me. A lot of companies in North Cyprus, or let me say a lot of people, don't want to employ foreigners in North Cyprus, especially us with this skin color. This is because with nobody accused, all right? This is because they know that some of us, we will not stay for long in the companies, all right? Most of the people that work in most of these companies in North Cyprus are Pakistanis, Indians, Philippines, a lot of them, all right? These are the majority, but not saying that we don't have blacks who work in North Cyprus. We have a lot of them. In fact, I knew two that were working with one metal company. A lot of them work with a company in Kyrenia. I know people in Kyrenia who work with a company. All right. Sorry. I know a lot of Nigerians who work with one company in Kyrenia. I'm not going to call the name because of security issues. So it doesn't change the fact that we are not working. We are working, all right? But a lot of these companies will not want to employ us because they know we will not stick to the rules of the job, all right? And your employee, like I said before, is the only person who will get you this document. And most employers, let me say the people employing you or companies, they are always afraid sometimes to give you these contracts because they know that, let me say, they are always afraid to give us these contracts because they know that sometimes, because in North Cyprus, anything that happens, the person working for you has no problem, all right? You as the employer bears majority of the problem. That is, if there is shortages of something, if there are insurance, if there is an increase or money something, you that employed me, you are the one to pay for all those charges, all right? So that is why most of these people, they don't want to employ internationals, all right? I hope you understand why. Yes, your employer does not, let me say there are some employers that will always delay to produce your documents, all right? You have to follow your employer, follow them up so that they can get your permit done, okay? Now, for you to get the permit, they will tell you somewhere. Before, you could go to, there was a hospital in Kyrenia that I know that all the workers in Kyrenia used to go there. In fact, for those who are in Cyprus, or if you move to Cyprus and you are in Kyrenia, there is a tall building around the Lefkosia roundabout in Kyrenia. The roundabout moving to Lefkosia, the building on your right hand side, all right, I know everything in that building. I have been there before. I'm not going to call the name of the owner because of issues, all right? So that is what you need to know. And the people I used to work with, I used to work with some Pakistanis. I don't know if they are still there or not, but they were very good guys. So Pakistani people are very good people. So I know all of them. We still talk up to date. So, like I said, that is how it looks like in North Cyprus, all right? You are not the one doing your permit. Now, that is for the case you get a job in North Cyprus, all right? Now, in the case you are a visitor, you came in using maybe a visitor's name or somebody invited you into North Cyprus and you came into North Cyprus and got a job, all right, with a company, you still have the same thing, all right? Your employer still needs to go for an authorization letter for you. Then, after that authorization, he or she needs to follow up with your working contract, all right? Or let me say your working permit, because it's very necessary. If you work in North Cyprus and you don't have the working permit, you are illegal, all right? So these are some of the things you need to know. You need to understand some of these things so that at the end of the day, you don't have issues. Now, I know a lot of international students work in North Cyprus without this document. Yes, that is because they are students, and I'm still coming to the part. Students can work in North Cyprus, but a lot of companies would not want to work with students. The reason is because at the end of the day, like I said before, any cause, any issue lands on the body of the employee, all right? You, the body of the employer. You as the employee, you don't have a problem, all right? So that is what you need to understand. Or the company that that gave you the job is going to carry all the cross or the blame. So that is why most people, they don't want to employ students. And students who are BSc holders cannot work in North Cyprus for the first year, all right? Only masters, or let me say graduate students, masters and PhD students are allowed to work in North Cyprus. That is why I always insist that if you are moving to North Cyprus as a student, all right, try to get your tuition fee, especially the bachelor's degree students, or try to get someone to sponsor you, because you may not have time to work. You have a lot of courses, about 35 to 40 courses to complete within 4 years, all right? You may not have time to do these jobs that a master's student with 7 courses will be doing, all right? And remember, they are not doing only for 1 semester. So that is how it is in now Cyprus. I hope you understand this little.